Welcome to two examples of determining probability of events that are not mutually exclusive. If it is possible for two events to occur at the same time, the events are not mutually exclusive. So if events A and B are not mutually exclusive, then the probability of A or B is equal to the probability of A plus the probability of B minus the probability of A and B. From our two examples, we'll see why we have to subtract this probability here. So first, one card is selected from a deck of playing cards. What is the probability it is a club or a face card? So because a card can be both a club and a face card, these two events are not mutually exclusive, and therefore to find this probability, we'll find the probability that the card is a club, and then we'll add the probability of a face card, but then we'll subtract the probability the card is a club and a face card. So remember, our deck of cards has 52 cards. There would be 13 clubs. That would be this suit here. And there are 12 face cards. We have the jack, queen, and king of all three suits. And therefore, the probability of a club would be 13 out of 52, plus the probability of a face card, that would be 12 out of 52. But now we have to subtract the probability that the card would be a club and a face card. The reason we have to do this is that notice that the cards that are both clubs and face cards, or these three cards here, were included in the favorable number of ways for both the clubs and the face cards. So these three cards were counted twice, and therefore we have to subtract this probability here, which should be 3 out of 52. So we have a common denominator of 52. The numerator is going to be 13 plus 12, that's 25, minus 3, that's 22. Now if we stop here for a moment, notice how this is telling us there are 22 favorable ways to pick a card that is a club or a face card out of 52. So if we were to clear this for a moment, if we identified the cards that were clubs or face cards and only counted them once, that would be these cards here. And that would be 22 cards out of 52. But this fraction does simplify. The common factor of 2, this simplifies to 11/26. Let's go ahead and get this as a decimal as well. 11 divided by 26 would give us the decimal value. So it's approximately 0.4231. So as a percentage, we would multiply by 100, add a percent symbol, that's approximately 42.31%. To convert this to a percentage, we would multiply by 100, add a percent symbol, or move the decimal point to the right two places, that would be 42.31%. Let's take a look at our second example. 20 ping pong balls are numbered from 1 to 20. What is the probability of selecting one ball and it is odd or less than 5? Again, these two events are not mutually exclusive because a ball can be odd and less than 5 at the same time, and therefore our probability will be equal to the probability of the ball being odd plus the probability the ball is less than 5 minus the probability that the ball is odd and less than 5. Well, if we consider the numbers from 1 to 20, 10 of these numbers would be odd. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, and so on. So the probability the ball would be odd would be 10/20, plus the probability that the ball would be less than 5. Well, the balls that are less than 5 would be 1 through 4. So the probability being less than 5 would be 4/20. But notice how we counted the number 3 and the number 1 in both probabilities, and therefore now we have to subtract the probability that the ball would be both odd and less than 5, which would be when the ball is 1 and 3. Therefore we have to subtract 2 out of 20 or 2 20ths. So we have 20 as a denominator, and then we have 10 plus 4, that's 14, minus 2, that's 12. Common factor of 4. So we have 3 fifths, which is equal to 3 divided by 5, or 0.6, or 60%. And notice how if we just stop and focus on 12 20ths for a moment, if we were to clear our work below and identify the numbers that are odd or less than 5, if we're starting at 1, 1 is odd, 2 is less than 5, 3 is odd, 4 is less than 5, 5 is odd, 6 is not odd, and it's also not less than 5. So from here we just select the odds. So 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17, 19. Notice how there are 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 favorable ways out of 20, which we have here using the formula, to select a ball that is odd or less than 5. Because these two examples are pretty straightforward, we could probably just count the favorable number of ways that these events could occur. But it's also a nice way to understand why we have this special formula when we have events that are not mutually exclusive. I hope you found these two examples helpful.